I, the prisoner in the Lord, implore you to lead a life worthy of your vocation. Bear with one another charitably, in complete selflessness, gentleness, and patience. Do all you can to preserve the unity of the Spirit by the peace that binds you together. There is one body, one Spirit, just as you were all called into one, and the same hope when you were called. There is one Lord, one faith, one baptism, and one God who is Father of all, over all, through all, and within all. Each of us, however, has been given his own share of grace, even as Christ allotted it. And to some, his gift was that they should be apostles, to some prophets, to some evangelists, to some pastors and teachers, so that the saints together make a unity in the work of service, building up the body of Christ. In this way, we are all to come to unity in our faith and in our knowledge of the Son of God, until we become the perfect man, fully mature with the fullness of Christ himself. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial stance.
Responsorial stance. The words go forth to all the earth.
The breath goes forth to all the earth.
The heavens proclaim the glory of God, and the firmament shows forth the work of his hands. Day unto day takes up the story, and night unto night makes known the message, response.
The word goes forth through all the earth.
Noise speaks no words, no voice is heard, yet their spasm goes forth through all the earth. The words to the utmost bounds of all the world respond.
The word goes forth through all the earth.
Doing, but he called an important job, the job of appointing his
intermediate, to co-workers in faith, all night in prayer. Very important message for us here too, but indeed we remain faithful to prayer in order that the task that the Lord has given us we fulfill to the best of our ability. Now secondly, you see how many people came to him, because it says that power came from him and they were all killed. We rely especially on the intercession of St. Jude, that through his help, we indeed may be healed from any illness that may be affecting us or anyone in our family. Because when we shortly have the anointing, just don't think of yourself, think of your family, your friends, those you know who are in need of healing in whatever way. And then we saw in our first reading there from St. Paul to the Ephesians, but although he's in prison, he thinks of his flock and he writes to them. And he has beautiful words there, lead and life, worthy of your vocation. May our prayer be that today, but especially following the example of St. Jude, who was even prepared to give his life for the Lord. Lead and life, worthy of our vocation. He brings out in that reading there that everyone has been given the task in the kingdom of God, that our prayer be today, that indeed we fulfill that as well as we can. So we just pray in the silence of our hearts for a moment for that intention. And now we go over to the blessing of the oil with the relic of St. Jude. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Loving God, we praise your name, for you have given us your Son Jesus Christ, to be our brother, our healer, our Savior. We ask you now to bless and sanctify this soothing oil as a sign of your love for us all. Through the intercession of St. Jude, may all who use this oil find strength and comfort and courage to bear their cross with Jesus. Pour your Spirit into our hearts to bring us your consolation and let us know your healing touch. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I will give the anointing here in the front. Johan will give me a hand. He will be doing it at the back, actually right in the tapestry, so that people can turn back to the lady chapel to their seats. So you go to the back and direct the people to it, because you've seen it in the tapestry.
Thank you. Thank you. Cause me to drink Pilgrims to the strife for Jude and their families. We pray
pray for the love of mercy and compassion. We'll listen to their petitions and grant their comfort and peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For the sick and afflicted, let us pray for the many who suffer in various ways, spiritually, mentally, and physically, that the Lord of compassion will comfort and heal them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our benefactors, let us pray for the many who have helped us by their prayers and in some other ways, and that their reward will be grace in God. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For drug addicts and alcoholics, let us pray for those afflicted, that they will be helped to overcome their addiction. We pray for their families, that they may be supported during the time of trial. Now young people protected from all harm. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For ourselves, with faith and confidence in the love and generosity of our God, may now bring forth our own needs, and those who have lost us, pray for them. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
We now unite our prayers with those of our mother as we pray together.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hear our prayers, gracious and loving God. As we pray for others, may our faith be strengthened, our anxieties relieved, our requests be granted according to your will. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now the offer to be given will be prepared. During this, we will have the collection. The collection is for the upkeep of the Shrine of St. Jude. And now, the offer to the collection is the gift will be brought up together. The monthly collection is taking place.
Take over.
Come age to age together and people for yourselves, so that from the righteous the Son can attain. And further offering may be made to the glory of your name. And so, Father, we bring these gifts. We ask you to meet them humbly by the power of your Spirit, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate the Eucharist. On the night he was betrayed, he took bread and gave you thanks and praise. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again he gave you thanks and praise, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." Let us comprehend the mystery of faith.
have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
This is our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to receive him.
Lord, I'm not worthy to receive thee, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Communion will be given out in the front here, but also in the sacristy where the anointing was done. That will be done by Johan and our mother's Torsten.
Thank you. in the silence of our hearts, let us thank Almighty God for the moment. For the gifts we have received, the gift of His Word, His sacrament, or His blessing, but today particularly to the gift of some Jude. Let us pray. Lord, we have received your sacrament humbly. Pray that through the intercession of your holy apostle Jude Thaddeus, the homage we offer in memory of his martyrdom may make us worthy in your sight and bring us into your kingdom. This we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And let us pray for God's blessing at the end of each prayer, this Amen. May God, who founded this church upon the apostles, bless you through the prayers of St. Jude.
Amen.
May God inspire you to follow the example of the apostles and give witness to the truth before all the world.
Amen.
The teaching of the apostles has strengthened your faith. May the prayers lead you to your true and eternal home.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Lord and Savior, go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you all for being with us. Special thanks to all those who ministered in any way, and a particular thanks to our musicians and singers. Well done. There's another Mass at 3 o'clock, really here. Now, if anyone of you has bought a religious object and want to have them back, just think of them, and I will bless them for you. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, descend upon these religious objects, and may many blessings to all who use them. And this we pray for Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Our final hymn is number 4.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is a like you. All of my needs I want to praise the wonders of the mighty I sing for joy.